that we should be going soon.
I think, are we live? I think we're live, Sam.
I think we are live.
Well, welcome everybody. What are they watching, Sam?
Well, if you are tuning in right now, you are watching Carolina Retirement Planners Happy Half Hour. We come to you live every Thursday at 4:30 to bring you some kind of bit of wisdom or some kind of financial tidbit, surrounded by some good-hearted fun here on a nice Thursday afternoon. This one is particularly beautiful.
Oh my gosh, I haven't been outside today.
Spring would come in February, you know?
I know, it's so gorgeous today. But I'm Samantha Shukavage, and with me is my father, David Shukavage. Hey, Dave, he is the president and founder of Carolina Retirement Planners. And behind the scenes, making the magic happen, is Amy Dresky, our director of client fun.
Hi, how are you guys?
Hi, Amy.
Hello. You know, it is. It's like an early spring. So the groundhog was totally wrong, right? Unless something happens weird.
Yeah, it appears that way.
Definitely wrong. Yeah.
I'm not sure the groundhogs are any better at, you know, predicting weather as our weather people, you know?
No, I don't think so either.
I had seen a post that said that we were going to have, at least in our region, going to have an unusually temperate winter. Like our January and February and March were going to be unusually warm, which I think that we have mostly experienced. I think no real threat of snow. It's been very nice.
Before we get into too much chit chat, I just want to remind folks that today our topic are the three stages of retirement, what they are and how to get the most from it. So, but we always like to start with something fun.
Yep. And I want to remind everybody that at the end, we will be doing, as always, a wine raffle where we raffle off two bottles of wine. So I hope you got your entries in this week. But we do this every week. So if you didn't get your entry in this week, I'll tell you at the end how to enter and you can get them in for next week.
Sounds good. I know it's the high point for many people, especially the winners, you know, little pun there. But I just say, let's see. And we also like to celebrate, you know, what day it is. What's special about today?
Yeah.
Last week, what was last week? Last week was, what was the week last week?
National Pizza Day.
National Pizza Day. Look for where the best pizza was. We had the shake day before that. What's today, Amy?
Today is Fat Thursday. Bum, bum,
Fat
bum.
Thursday.
Yeah. I always say, did you get your punch keys? I mean, people probably don't know what that is, or some do, but yeah.
I did a little bit of research, and you know, most people, I would say, are familiar with Fat Tuesday, which is the day before Ash Wednesday, which is the start of Lent. And, but in Poland in particular, there might be other countries, but it's very Polish. The Poland celebrates their kind of Fat Tuesday on Fat Thursday instead, where they choose to be, debaucherous, by indulging in, and Amy, what do you call it?
It's a punch key.
A punch key.
Yeah.
Punch which key. Is basically, I just Googled and looked at beautiful images of them, and I'm very hungry now, of just like beautiful filled donuts with all kinds of things on top. So they
anybody out there in our audience knows where you can get punch keys here, let us know.
Mm-hmm. Well, if you've had a punch key, if you know where to get them, if this is a tradition for you. But In the Fat Thursday, Fat Tuesday spirit, we Amy in our email this week asked everybody what their favorite comfort food was, what they went to if they really wanted to indulge and feel nice and comforted.
You know what one?
What one?
Chocolate, by far. Chocolate. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we did. I would like to say, I don't know if I was joking or not. I'm going to like to think it's not. We did have a vote for pickled herring, and somebody voted pickled okra, but the pickled herring is, you know, I love that stuff.
So. I like pickled herring too.
Me too.
It's sure it's exactly a comfort food, no, but it may be a little too stimulating, but you know, but still.
It's yummy. We also had some bean soup and some like mashed potatoes and mac and cheese. And then I would like to know, what's your comfort food? You guys can share what you guys prefer.
Oh, as I was telling y'all before we got on, number one, above all, not even close, no contest. My number one comfort food is macaroni and cheese. Absolutely. If I'm having a bad day, don't feel well, need a pick me up, just want to feel warm and comforted inside, give me a bowl of mac and cheese and I will feel better.
Mine would probably be a toss up between mashed potatoes and pad thai. A good Thai hot pad thai.
You know what? I love the soup from Indochine when you're thinking about that kind of food. Yeah. They make great soup.
Yeah. Or dumplings. We don't have a good dim sum place here. Yeah. But if we had a true dim sum place, oh my goodness, that would be a very close second. Any kind of noodles, really.
Yeah, my wife makes a really good pesto sauce and noodle. Oh, it's another thing I just can't stop eating. So
what about you, Amy?
Yeah, I said Doritos with fresh salsa, but I'm good with all of those. I also forgot we had a vote for some pasta. I mean, pasta is always good. There's turnip barking in the background, but yeah, pasta is another one that I love too. But yeah, I like Doritos with fresh salsa. I mean, it's a weird thing, I know, but yeah.
And we also have been joined by Bruce, who hope we had a wonderful Valentine's Day. And Ed is here, and Kristen is here. She says the top ramen for sure, and a grilled cheese sandwich. Grilled cheese sandwich is another good one.
Mom would always make my grilled cheese sandwich, and then with like a bowl of tomato soup. So I always like have, if I can't have tomato soup, I'll take a little bit of ketchup too. There's something about the tomato and the grilled cheese together that's.
I agree.
It's so Gail funny. Says, Gail says, bring on spring, which I can agree with. Hi, Brenda. Our own Brenda is here, says hello. Teresa, our
one of us.
Just, you know, you.
Our delightful regular.
Yes. Bill, it's good to see you. And
Jean and Debbie are here.
Yeah, as it's another. So we may want to get going with the educational part of the program.
Absolutely. Well, now I'm properly hungry. So let's go.
Well, let me ask you something. We're talking about three stages of retirement, but if we step back a little further, you know, life has more than three stages. What's the predecessor to retirement?
Well, it's about your accumulation phase versus your distribution phase. So when you're working, you're in your accumulation phase. So at that point, you know, you get a paycheck every week. Typically you'll get a paycheck, you'll pay your taxes, you'll put some away, you'll spend what's left. And the stuff that you put away, you know, into a 401k, 403b, IRA, retirement, you know, any kind of investment account, you're accumulating that. You're letting that grow for the future, for later.
It's also a great phase because you do know where your money's coming from every week or month.
Yeah, exactly. Your income is predictable and all the money that you're socking away is just, you're socking it away and it's growing for later. And then all of a sudden you retire and that income goes away. You're basically laid off for the next 30, 40 years. And so you have to figure out, what is my income? Where is my income coming from? And for most of you, you start entering the distribution phase where you are not putting money into those retirement accounts, those investment accounts anymore. You are now pulling money from those accounts. So that is a really big shift for everybody who retires.
And those years of retirement are not all the same. And sometimes it's nice to have a model for how it works. So one way you can model it, sort of dependent on what age you are. And let's say we have the age from 60, let me use a different color there, make it a little more interesting.
Absolutely. Gotta keep it fresh there, Dad.
Yeah, gotta keep it. Simulated. Let's say you might retire around age 60 or then up to age, oh, say 75. We call this the go-go years. And, you know, these are the years I like to say your knees and your hips are probably still original equipment, you know, and you got a lot of energy and go, and the thought of, hey, let's go somewhere. In fact, we have a lot of clients who have a lot of friends, and it's not unusual for them, you know, a group to say, let's go to Australia for 3 weeks, and they'll get on a plane and fly for, I don't know, 24 hours or so to get to the other side of the world and run all over the place, or go to Europe and crawl around castles and all this stuff. These are the go-go years. You have the energy and to do that. The other thing about those years is, you know, one thing we often like to do is spoil our grandchildren. But in these go-go years, the grandkids are kind of this high, you know, and grandparents are for them fun. It's like, hey, grandma, granddad, hey, take me to Disneyland, take me on a Disney cruise, do things with me. They enjoy your company. You are still a novelty, fun to them. And you want to spend the time and the money to go out and take them in and build memories with them when they still want to build memories with you.
Yeah,
that is so, so true. 100%.
Absolutely. You know, you could also just want to go out drinking, eating, and dancing until the wee hours of the morning every night.
No. Yeah, we often like to joke, like what kind of things do you buy in your go-go years? And we thought about going down to one of those vintage clothing stores and getting a pair of go-go boots, you know?
Yes, it's just, I love it.
And you're probably still out dancing and doing things like that. So those are really great years. Next comes age 75 to about age 85. We'll call this the slow go years. You know, during these years, yeah, you're still doing things, you know, but boy, after a while, the idea I'm going to get on a plane and fly or someplace else in the world gets a little old. You don't want to necessarily do that every year. You're traveling less. You're probably going to more doctor's appointments during this phase. May even be going to some funerals, you know? So this is where, you
this
know,
is you're, where you might be enjoying more bridge nights than nights at the disco.
Yeah, you're kind of easing off.
I like that, yeah.
So I do, my mother-in-law loves bridge, and I've learned that you do not have, there is not an age restriction on the game of bridge.
That's
so
right.
I say that lightly.
keeps your mind sharp, you know? So you got the slow go years. And then finally you have the, from age 85 to 100 and maybe even beyond 100, you have the won't go years. You know, you're still around, but boy, the idea of flying anywhere isn't really in the cards. And you know, you're kind of home wearing out wearing out cushions on your rocking chair or such, you know, and
yeah.
your activities and maybe your spending has kind of been throttled back, where you're enjoying things in the house, less expensive, less things like that. So those are the three phases. Now, if you think about it, if we were to look at spending, if we were to look at spending during these years, in the go-go years, well, you're probably spending a lot. This is when you really want to go travel, enjoy the grandchildren, things like that. When you get to your slow-go years, you're probably going to taper off. And you know, as you get older, spend less. And then when you get to the won't-go years, you're probably going to level off. Now, Sam, why do you think it is that often people that have entered these retirement years don't really get to take advantage of the go-go years as much as they could?
Because they don't have a realistic expectation for how long their money's going to last. They're afraid to spend it.
Yeah, they're worried they're going to run out. Yeah. In fact, I've often sat here in this office, you know, and you'll have a couple just retiring and they're talking about, you know, what they're going to do in those early, those go-go years. And it's usually the lady that says, honey, this is great. You worked all your life. We worked all our life for this. We should go travel. We should have fun. Let's go, you know, see all the things we've wanted to. And the man sits there and says, nope, I don't want to run out of money. I'm afraid we're going to run out of money. We're going to just back off, you know? And, you know, that's if they don't have a plan for how much they can spend during these different phases, knowing that when they get out to 100, they still got some money left. Well, maybe not doing anything is the logical thing. You know, it's because without a plan, you're gonna be cautious. That's a natural caution. But if you have a plan that says, boy, I'm gonna spend more here during these years, I'm going to taper off and end up here. And I have a way to track it to see if I'm still on track for my plan. And I know I still have enough money. Then you can do that. You can go on and enjoy these kind of years. So that's the thing that good planning in retirement, we help people build these plans to say, hey, here's, am I on track for my retirement? Will I have enough? And gives them the confidence to spend more here. So, anything else? Can you think of anything else, Sam? Anything else about our three stages of retirement?
Nope. I think you hit the nail on the head there. I think it's essentially, you know, having an income plan is incredibly important to give you that peace of mind that you can spend your money and that you won't run out of money. And, that you, and then the knowledge on top of that, that you can structure your spending.
And you're investing your whole plan. There's a lot that comes to make this happen. When those years when you're laid off, and where's that paycheck going to come from then? So it should be fun. Now, if you know, clients know they can always call us if they have questions. We've said this. If you're a visitor, you can give us a call at the office and say, hey, I'd like to have a phone call or talk to you about your situation. We also have, as we often do, a giveaway. And this week, we're giving away a booklet on the changing story of retirement, Carolina Retirement Planners.
That's a good one.
And this is a good one, and it kind of expounds on this even more. How do they get this, Amy?
All they need to do is send an email to Mary. I'll put her email in the comment, in the comments, and I'll pin it. But it's mary@carolinarp.com, and she'll mail it over to you.
We're going to mail you a real one that you can hold in your hands. Trying to read this on a cell phone is just not going to be logical. So, okay, back to the other camera. There we go. So that's a little insight on that. Before we get to our wine drawing and fun things, what's our topic next week, Amy? Do you remember what we decided to do here on Happy Half Hour next week?
I sure do. Would you like to know what it is?
Yeah.
To tell everybody or okay. So we are
Well, if you tell me, you'll tell everybody.
I guess that's a good point. We are on the 23rd doing the Secure Act, you know, the Secure Act 2.0, and the plot thickens. Bum bum bum. So it's more about the changes and things that are going on with the Secure Act and
I think at the very end of last year they did the Secure Act. You remember the first Secure Act 1 eliminated the stretch IRA and did other things. The Secure Act 2 is playing around with RMD ages and playing around with a lot of other things that are sometimes subtle. And like most things, there's things that if you don't know, you aren't ready, will can hurt you. And things if you know about it, you can take advantage of. So we're going to cover it. We're going to cover the ins and outs of the Secure Act 2 next week here. Stuff that if you are one of those people that pay taxes, you probably want to know. You probably want to know about.
I think that's all of us, right? Do we all pay taxes? Yeah.
Pretty much. Actually,
I like it.
In the country, this is why it's even more important. I think about 40% of the people in the country don't pay taxes. They don't make enough to pay taxes. And so the remaining 60%, many of which are watching this, have to carry the load for that other 40, you know, and that load's getting bigger and bigger. That's why it's even more important to be proactive and do the things you might be able to do to reduce the taxes. And we're looking at taxes going out, not just this year, but really 5, 10, 20, 30 years. And taxes for your kids and your grandkids. So that's why it's important. So we'll talk about that. And I do believe we are starting tax classes next week too in Brunswick County. I think it's on Wednesday evening at the main campus at 6 o'clock, and Thursday morning at 10 o'clock at the North Campus by Compass Point, the Leland Center. So if you're interested in coming to one of those, give us a call. Invitations have gone out, but you'll probably be getting, if you're a client, you'll probably get an email. It'd be a great thing to, most of you come to these, but pass it on to friends. Because, you know, our classes, I like to think of, are not only informative, but a lot of fun. So. You want to get them to take advantage of it.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
Okay, so, well, it must be time for wine drawing.
I think it is. So every week we raffle off 2 bottles of wine delivered directly to your door from Fermental Bottle Shop. They are newly located in the Cargo District in downtown Wilmington. It is an awesome location. You should go check them out. You can have wine or beer on site, or you can pick it up to take home. It's actually just a cool area in general. There's lots of really cool businesses to go check out over there. A great way to spend an afternoon. But you don't have to go there to get the wine if you win. They will ship it directly to your door, personally curated 2 bottles. And to enter, all that you have to do is each week we have, you know, on your Facebook page, there'll be an event for each week. And you just say, I'm coming to this event. I'm attending. And we'll get you entered in there. If you share that event with a friend, we'll get you in there again. And if you're on our email listserv, we will send out an email every week to let you know what our topic is. And if you reply and let us know what your favorite comfort food is, what your favorite pizza topping is, or just say, get us in the wine drawing, we'll get you in there. And if you share that email with a friend and let us know you've done that, we'll get you in there an additional time. All right.
You're just totally trying to put names in there. I love that you touched on, I love that you touched on the little part here that Steve, who is the owner, he is actually hand picking those two bottles of wine. So there's a little process.
Not willy-nilly wines.
No, no.
Good bottles for you.
That's your individual person.
If you win, Amy will call you and kind of get to know you and your taste, and she matches it up with him to get just wine tailored for you. So
it's so great. I mean, I love what he does. He's so great.
And our winner this week,
Drumroll.
Two bottles of wine delivered directly to their door is Carol M.
Carol.
Congratulations,
congratulations, Carol. You are our wine winner.
Yay, congratulations. Oh, we love it. Thank you for joining us.
Yes. Thank you all for being here today.
Yeah.
I hope that you have a chance to go enjoy this beautiful afternoon.
I'm going to do it. I'll go outside.
I'm going to go take the dog for a long walk and watch the sunset.
Oh, I love it. It's so nice. I'm going to finish up, and I think I'm going to sit in the hot tub for a little bit after this. Why not?
Okay.
That sounds
good times. Great. Good times. Good times. So, and we'll see everybody next week.
So everyone cheers, and until our next week's happy half hour, have a great week. Have a great weekend.
Cheers. Thanks, guys.
Take care.